Hi there, I'm Harvey Wasserman from Youth3.org. David Crosby is here, he's representing also Honorary Jackson Harbor Grand National, who submitted statements for the shutdown of Diablo in the nuclear plant. We want the commission to recognize that we are in favor of a full employment for all the operators at Diablo Canyon. It will be shutting down. We hope that the operators at Diablo will stay on for the decommissioning process because they know the plant better than anybody. We also understand that when Diablo is shut, there will be many, many thousands of jobs in the renewable energy industry that will take up the, that will create more jobs, more wealth, and certainly be better for the environment than what Diablo Canyon is. We understand that since Diablo has come online, a dozen earthquake faults have been found within the proximity of the reactors. That needs to be discussed. We want to know what happened to Dr. Michael Peck, who was the president's safety inspector, who did report on the seismic dangers of Diablo Canyon, so that they cannot withstand the earthquakes there. We want Dr. Peck back at Diablo Canyon and his report dealt with properly. We also understand that there is embrittlement at these reactors, and there are water issues that the state of California needs to take up. The state of California can shut Diablo Canyon. It is not in compliance with the law on water quality standards in many different ways, and it's up to us as Californians to get the state to shut this reactor as soon as possible. We also want the evacuation plans looked at. Once again, we want to know about the crack and the dry casks at where there has been improper loading of spent fuel. And above all, we want to make it clear that Diablo Canyon will shut. We need it shut before the next earthquake. We want the people at the plant to continue to be there for the decommissioning process, and we look forward to the transition to renewable energy, to Solartopia, which is happening right now. And that's where the jobs are, that's where the economy is, that's where the future of this planet is. Thank you very much. We all know Diablo can be shut. The question is whether it's been shut before the earthquake destroys it and us. We have Dr. Peck at the plant, one of the leading experts in the entire Nuclear Regulatory Commission, who issued a report saying the reactors could not withstand a likely earthquake deliverable by the dozen faults there. If you get to relicensing, this has to be dealt with. Dr. Peck has to be brought back to Diablo Canyon out of exile. It's so rare that we get a candid report from inside the commission, and you need to look, and the entire commission needs to look much more closely at what Dr. Peck says about the dozen earthquake faults that have been found around Diablo. I was arrested at Diablo in 1984, where we're still arguing about the Hosby fault, and now there are a dozen there. I should also point out, you need to look at the fact that Diablo is 45 miles from the San Andreas fault, which is half as far as Fukushima was from the earthquake that destroyed it. You also need to look now at the tsunami issue. It's been generally poo-pooed, but the reality is that there are intake pipes at sea level and even below at Diablo Canyon that would be impacted by a tsunami, even if the reactors themselves are 85 feet in the air. That has to be looked at very closely. We are already having dry cast cracking in terms of the waste storage. There's embrittlement, there are evacuation issues. There are also health impacts. Since you will be looking at this, I co-authored a book called Killing Our Own in 1982. I interviewed people in central Pennsylvania after the Three Mile Island accident. It was the worst week of my life. I guarantee you people were killed at Three Mile Island. This needs to be revisited. And we also see a million person death toll documented at Chernobyl, and God knows what's going to happen at Fukushima. 300 tons of radioactive water are still pouring into the ocean there. I was in Japan when Fukushima was being opened. We were assured that, of course, nothing like an earthquake or tsunami could happen there that would destroy it. Finally, on the jobs impact, I'm not sure if you can look at the economic impacts in this particular proceeding, but everyone here who opposes Diablo should understand that the jobs are a real issue. We want a federal jobs program for all the people who are working at the reactors. We want them kept on for the decommissioning process, and we want them placed in the industry that does have a future in this country, which is renewable energy. And when you look at relicensing anything like this, you need to look at the economic and ecological impacts of the transition from an old decrepit nuclear power plant like Diablo into the world of solar panels, wind power, and all the stuff that actually does work and will create an environment in the future where our children and grandchildren can survive. Thank you very much for your time.